I was a vice president for, you know, SGA back home.
Last year, Rajesh Kodali was an Intu student from India. Now a grad student, Raj is an SGA senator for the College of Information and Technology.
Right now, like, Intu Marshall has got, like, pretty much 500 students. I would say Intu Marshall students have got all the equal rights with, you know, like a direct Marshall student. They pay the tuition, they live in the dorms, they pay for Marshall. So I think even they should have a voice.
This is exactly what some members of SGA are pushing for, a Senate seat for Intu students. However, Raj admits that this initiative is more complicated than it seems.
We have to take one thing into consideration, that Intu students are not full-time Marshall students.
Representation in SGA is typically reserved for permanent colleges, but SGA member Chandler Milam explains why he thinks Intu should be an exception.
The Intu program actually offers courses, which sets it apart and makes it very similar to, say, the Honors College.
Already this school year, a motion to add an Intu seat was passed here in Judiciary, but struck down in Senate. Judiciary Chairman Cody Hatton explains why.
With one seat from this group, they could have any group on campus come about and say, well, I want a seat, and I want a seat. And eventually, you have so many seats that you have to give that there's diversity is good, but that's a lot of seats.
However, Hatton is working to amend the Constitution so that large organizations such as Intu can be represented in student government. If approved, this change would then go to a student body-wide vote during the spring elections. Rob Engle, MU Report.
Meeting adjourned.